The major highlights from the report would be around the earnings that for the first six, more the last 6 months of 2016. There was quite a sharp decline. It was the largest decline we've seen since 2010-2011 of 5.2% in real terms compared to the same period in 2015. However, although that is quite a sharp decline, overall earnings for the last 5 or 7 years has been fairly flat. So moderate growth, not sharp declines as we've seen in the contracting industry. So although the decline is seen as a negative, I think overall the industry has been quite buoyant considering the broader economic environment. Some of the other important indicators that have come through is that perceptions around profitability seems to be stabilizing somewhat. More people are less negative, or more people are more confident pertaining to the outlook for profitability. Although profits are still fairly low compared to previous years, I think there's a new normal level coming into the industry. It's averaged from about 20% to about 11% at the moment, where 60% of those people are confident or are happy with those kind of levels. Well, there are several challenges affecting the engineering industry, and I think the first and the foremost of that is the economic environment that we're sitting in. I think the conditions that has happened in the first 6 months of this year will certainly play off in the next survey. We don't know how that impact will be, we'll have to see. But the low growth economic environment, weak investor confidence, and commodity prices are all playing a role affecting engineers' fees. I think also over and beyond that is a slow project pipeline, delivery at municipal and provincial levels, because the local government is quite an important client to the engineering industry. Skills levels within some of these client bodies can become an issue. We're seeing issues of non-Cesa members also participating in this environment, and that is also having effect on some of the pricing and the discounting that we see. So there's a wide range, but I think a lot of some of the issues are traditional issues. They're operational issues, they're there, they come up. Corruption, of course, is a major constraint at the moment. It's almost become part of our normal list of things affecting the industry. It doesn't make them less serious, but I think at this point in time, the economic environment in which we're sitting in and the access to funding in order to stimulate higher levels of infrastructure investment is probably our biggest constraint.